It took my brother and I 24 hours driving time to go 1,600 miles from my house to South Padre, Texas to watch the rocket launch.
Wow, look at all this. It's gotta be all employees, man. When we were here last time, none of these cars were here.
Nope.
All right, I'll get a shot of you.
Yeah. So it's November 18th, 2024, right at the Space Garden.
This guy won't let us any closer, man.
You got it early then, didn't you?
Yeah, fairly early. We got our order request in January.
We haven't had any issues with ours. We've got the two recalls on it.
The QR code about?
It's our next big event. We do these national Tesla meets.
He takes his phone and clicks on that.
Yeah, he just takes you to the website.
A whole truck load up on the freeway heading toward California on the way out.
Yeah. How do you like self-driving, or do you use the self-driving?
We use it probably 90% of the time.
Okay, so you obviously you like it if most of the time.
We do. So we've had a Tesla since early 2017.
Oh, wow. Yeah, really.
So the first 9,500 miles on this, we had to drive it, which, it's got the four-wheel steering and the steer-by-wire.
Yeah.
So no physical connection between the steering wheel. It makes it so easy to drive.
So that second tower wasn't even there the last time you were here.
No, not even there. In fact, the first tower got destroyed by the first launch, the whole base.
So it dug a pit 30 feet deep.
Oh, yeah, no, it totally
did. I knew it dug a pit, but I didn't think it was 30 feet.
We're walking from the SpaceX sign to the beach. As you can see, there are certainly Cybertrucks on the way. If you look ahead, you can see the ocean. Here's a view that I really liked.
Yeah, I like this view.
Yeah.
We can get even closer. I was astounded the day before the rocket went up that they actually let you come this close. Look how gigantic these things really are. See the person walking, and now, as I zoom up, this right here is where they load the propellant, and these chopsticks grab the booster when it returns, and in the future, the rocket as well.
Yeah, the other guy just moved right
now like that.
Oh, there it goes!
Musk wanted to know on the first launch, if they built a strong enough pad, could they get away without pumping up water like they do now? And these rocks are still all around the rocket for about a mile. So the solution is pump a bunch of water up before the rocket ignites. We were hoping they would catch the booster like they did on launch 5. This was launch 6. But because this antenna got bent, they decided not to risk it and landed it 23 miles out in the Gulf of Mexico, and then it fell over and exploded. Now I'm going to zoom in on these chopsticks so you can get an idea of how gigantic they really are. If you look, there's a man working on the chopsticks that I'm zooming into, and then I zoom back out so you can get an idea of how big these chopsticks really are that catch the boosters. Yes, the film is jerky, but it'll give you an idea of how many people actually showed up. Another suggestion I make, if you do set up a tripod, do it on the water's edge. Otherwise, something like this might happen. 1 minute before the launch went up, a lady stood right in front of my camera. Fortunately, my brother noticed this, and he politely asked her to move, which of course she did. And the same thing might happen to you. So I suggest setting the tripods up to where there's actually a little bit of water that gets on the bottom of the tripod to make sure nobody gets in your way. Those boats out in the harbor, they're moving around and they might block your launch, so keep that in mind wherever you set your tripod up. There were people camping on the beach, pretty close to where the rocket went up. Whether that is legal or not, I do not know. I tried to see online whether it was legal and I got mixed results. Some said it was legal to camp there, others said it wasn't. I know for sure, I don't care where you're camped on that beach, they will run you out before that rocket goes up. You can drive up and down that beach a couple of miles in either direction. My brother and I did it, but I will warn you, the first 100 feet where the sand is soft, you do not want to have your truck stop, otherwise you'll get stuck. We backed up, got some momentum, and cut right through the sand till we hit the wet sand and then drove up and down the beach. About 30 minutes from where the rocket goes up, near the freeway, there is a Love's gas station that if you pay $18, you can get a shower at. In Texas, they can have some wicked thunderstorms, so definitely check the weather if you plan on camping. Also, there are mosquitoes, so make sure you bring a tent that can keep the mosquitoes out. South Padre Island is a tourist island. It has plenty of restaurants and hotels. We stayed at this one. It normally costs $60 a night, but during the launch window, they charged $120, so that's what we paid. It took about 20 to 30 minutes to walk where we filmed the rocket from that hotel. The crowd gets thicker as you get closer to the beach. And it took about an hour for us to drive from the hotel to this spot where they build the rockets. And it only takes about 10 minutes from here to drive down to the beach where I was filming the rocket from the dunes. I'm now zooming in across the bay to South Padre Island. Over here is where we watched the launch from. It's about 5 miles away from where the rocket went up. This yellow line is the Mexican border. Other people watch it from Mexico. Here it is only about 4 miles or less away from where the rocket goes up. Keep in mind, this beach in Mexico is right next to Matamoros City, and the State Department has it under a Level 4 Do Not Travel advisory. Consider this before you cross the border. If you still decide to go to Mexico for the launch, a passport or passport card is highly recommended for easy entry. Other options are Trusted Traveler Program cards, Enhanced Driver's License, EDLs, in other words. Don't confuse this with a Real ID driver's license. Believe it or not, a Real ID driver's license may allow you into Mexico for short stays, but it's not accepted for re-entry back into the U.S. It's free to walk into Isla Blanca Park, but there is a fee to drive in. This is the gate entrance where you pay, and they only accept cash, no credit cards. Be sure to book your campsite in advance, especially during peak season like launch day. And keep in mind, parking just a few hours before launch may have lines, and it may be full. I'll leave a link to the park's website down below. Daily parking passes are $12, 30-day passes $30, and yearly passes are $100. Veterans get a discount of 50% or more, but bring credentials. RV camping is around $50 a night, and tent camping is around $20. Prices vary depending on the seasons. Veterans get no discounts for camping. The park has restrooms, showers, picnic areas, and a playground. Next year, 2025, SpaceX aims for 25 launches and, eventually, daily launches. Falcon rocket launches, especially those after sunset, are truly spectacular. I suspect it'll be the same for these mega rockets. Just 8 years ago, boosters were still let to fall at sea and got red hot as they fell. Witnessing my first launch, captured on my cell phone, was a surreal experience. Appropriate Amazon affiliate links and the other links mentioned are down below.
Unfortunately, I get home and this is what my footage sounds like.
Saturday morning. And I said, hey, you know what? It's delayed till Tuesday. We got time. We got time to go. That's my brother. Like, you know, nice. Spur of the moment, you know?
Yeah.
That's the best place.
You know what?
That's the best place.
Yeah, yeah. There by
the beach just like yeah, the beach. Up.
That wind noise, I did the best I could to clean it up with Audacity. And I'll leave some Amazon affiliate links down below to help you with this problem. I brought this camera, which I love. Because it's so simple to use, you just open this up, hit record, and you're recording. Close it, and it just shuts itself off. Bring a windsock for whatever type of camera you have. I do realize most people don't use that kind of camera. They actually use a cell phone. So I went on Amazon and looked at what I would buy if I used my cell phone. And they sell these little receivers that go here that plug into the bottom of this. And then two lavalier mics that you can put on. But what I liked about that product was it came with both the foam rubber windsocks and the little furry ones. And on a camera like this, I would probably find where the microphone is and just tape the furry one over it, unless I'm using the lavalier microphone itself. But that product works for both Apple and Android. I'm leaving an Amazon affiliate link down below. Another product I'm leaving an Amazon affiliate link to is this, in case you've never seen these, where you just plug that into your phone. It's just a magnet. You get it near it, and it clicks in like that. The other end, just right here, it's just a USB port. Any 5-volt charger that uses USB will work. I don't just use it for phones, though. I actually use it for a bunch of my products. I use it for my mouse to charge it. I use it for my computer board to charge it. And you don't have to worry about, you can pull it off like that. You don't have to worry about bending any wires or anything when you're plugging the charger in to charge your phone or your computer or whatever it is. So I'm leaving an Amazon affiliate link for it as well. If anyone knows the legal status of camping on that beach near the rocket, please leave a comment below to let people know. This is Ron from Fixing Stuff in Black and White, signing off.